Human minds have been captivated by riddles for a long time, as they challenge our intellect and problem-solving abilities. With the rise of artificial intelligence, of course people have put computers to the test to see if AI can decipher the most perplexing riddles in history. In this video, we explore the potential of AI in solving the hardest riddles in history, including its advancements, limitations, and the interplay between human ingenuity and machine intelligence. Let's start with the insanely difficult 100 hat riddle. In 2016, Google DeepMind developed an algorithm to be able to resolve the 100 hat riddle, which is said to require such high levels of lateral thinking and problem solving that it has been asked during interviews for investment bank Goldman Sachs, and ironically, Google itself. This is what the riddle is. An executioner lines up 100 prisoners, single file, and puts a red or blue hat on each prisoner's head. Every prisoner can see the hats of the people in front of him in the line, but not his own hat, nor those of anyone behind him. There is also an unknown number of red or blue hats. The executioner starts at the end of the line and asks the last prisoner the color of his hat. The prisoner must answer either red or blue. If he answers correctly, he is allowed to live. But if he gives the wrong answer, he is killed instantly and silently. While everyone hears the answer, no one knows whether it is right. Before lining up, the prisoners are allowed to collectively come up with a strategy. What should they do? A team from the University of Oxford, the Canadian Institute for Advanced Research, and Google's DeepMind created an AI called Deep Distributed Recurrent Queue Networks to tackle the 100 hats riddle, which it had no problem in creating a solution. Its best strategy resulted in 99 of the prisoners surviving and one remaining prisoner having a 50% chance of survival. In solving this riddle, the AI even outperformed baseline methods to prove that it could come up with communications protocols internally. The solution's complexity also demonstrated the intense level of data that the AI's deep neural networks can process, which is such a high level of data that it can create the same results as a group of humans. The adoption of AI and machine learning techniques in problem solving and riddle solving have sped up research in resolving missing or ambiguous pieces of history, and has been helping scientists and historians since 2020 with what may be considered as overlooked information in an approach called digital humanities. This came after IBM Japan and Yamagata University presented the world's first AI-identified hieroglyph in 2019. The task required massive amounts of high-resolution data, which IBM had taken up as a challenge to test its AI. Google's AI lab, DeepMind, has also targeted ancient mysteries using similar principles and technology. One of its scientists, Yanis Asale, did research work with Oxford University historian Thea Sommershield on a deep learning model called Pythia, which was designed to fill the gaps of missing text in ancient Greek inscriptions. In other words, an AI tool for historians is based on a technique that helps neural networks make transparent decisions. GPT-3, which is a neural network machine learning model, was tested last year to see how it used its logic and reasoning abilities to solve riddles, which it didn't do too well, scoring 2 out of 5. The riddles were: what flattens all mountains, wipes out all species, destroys every building, and turns everything into pieces. Second, you see a boat filled with people. It has not sunk, but when you look again, you don't see a single person on the boat. Why? Third, Lily is a lily pad in a small pond. Lily doubles her size each day. On the 20th day, she covers the whole pond. On what day was Lily half the size of the pond? Fourth, I am the black child of a white father, like a wingless bird flying even to the clouds of heaven. I give birth to tears of mourning in pupils that meet me. Even though there is no cause for grief, on my birth, I am dissolved into thin air. What am I? And number 5, Michael is a 31-year-old man from America. He is at that really famous museum in France, looking at its most famous painting. However, the artist who made this painting just makes Michael think of its favorite cartoon character from his childhood. What was the country of the origin of the thing that the cartoon character usually holds in his hand? GPT-3 was only able to answer the first and fourth riddles correctly, which were fairly easier to answer, and in this article on it, the person who had tested GPT-3 reasoned that some of the more difficult riddles were about specific cultural references or things that require extensive knowledge about the world. These riddles are certainly not history's most difficult ones, but it goes to show that AI is not as almighty as some people might consider it to be. In January this year, ABP News Bureau also decided to put ChatGPT to the test with a riddle that it had taken from a tweet by AI for Diversity founder Steve Nori. The riddle was, Harry's mom has four kids. Three of them are named Shayak, Mikrat, and Shiriya. What is the name of the fourth kid? ChatGPT responded, it is not specified in the information provided what the name of the fourth child is, which led ABP News Bureau to think that ChatGPT had failed. It then explained to ChatGPT that the answer to the riddle was in the riddle itself, which prompted ChatGPT to respond, I apologize. The name of the fourth child is Harry. When it was asked the same riddle again, ChatGPT replied, the name of the fourth child is Harry. In its article on the test, ABP Bureau called ChatGPT's second answer the magic of machine learning and explained that scientists had trained it using two models, supervised learning and reinforcement learning. The article read that supervised learning involves a human trainer trying to improve ChatGPT's performance by providing conversations while playing both the roles of the AI assistant and the user. While in reinforcement training, the human trainer ranks ChatGPT's generated responses to fine-tune its problem-solving capabilities, after which ChatGPT uses the ranks to understand and provide better answers to queries. Similarly, earlier this year, Kenna Hughes Castleberry, who is a science communicator at JILA, a joint physics research institute between the National Institute of Standards and Technology and the University of Colorado Boulder, challenged AI developers to solve the nearly century-old riddle from Cain's Jawbone, a murder mystery puzzle book from 1934. The writer of the puzzle, Edward Mathers, had deliberately published the book with all its 100 pages out of order, and the readers first have to reorder the pages to be able to crack the case and name the six murderers and their victims. Figuring out the answer is no easy task, also because it contains false clues, and only four people were able to solve it a few years before Kenna Hughes Castleberry's experiment. She was aware that most AIs are not trained specifically to reorder book pages or to analyze the stylized version of 1930s English, and her quest led her to Zindi, a company in Africa that hosts AI competitions in which 50,000 data scientists use algorithms to solve puzzles and win prizes. The participants in the competition initially began their work using Google's NLP model, BERT. They were first provided Agatha Christie's first mystery novel, The Mysterious Affair at Stiles, to use as training data based on the reasoning that it had been written during the same time period, used similar language, and contained context clues of a classic mystery. One of the winners was M.G. Ferreira, an econometrician from South Africa, who had the highest score of 42%, which meant that his program had correctly ordered 42 out of 100 pages of Cain's Jawbone. He explained that NLP comprehension had been stumped by the fake clues in the book, and that AI needs a human to intervene to help it put the right clues together. Ferreira added, going in that direction, eventually we will be able to solve the whole thing. But by that time, the NLP will be such a small part, and the human overlay will be such a big part, that I'd call it machine-assisted. In her article on this experiment, that was published in April this year, Kenna Hughes Castleberry stated that she now believes that NLP models are not good enough to analyze data without context, and this could be a problem for researchers who are in the favor of using NLPs to analyze ancient languages. She explained that because there are limited historical records on some ancient and dead civilizations, lack of context make it difficult for AI to learn how to translate their lost languages. This is another reason why, besides a lack of funding, the field of digital humanities, which does have some potential, remains underused for now. Sure, AI has had substantial success in riddle solving and shows considerable promise, but it still has limitations in replicating certain aspects of human intelligence, which is why, as Ferreira pointed out, a collaborative approach that combines AI's analytical capabilities with human expertise is what is viable for the foreseeable future. At this point in time, AI's analytical analysis of datasets from various fields such as literature and historical texts is what helps it to purpose answers that align with human intuition, and research and development efforts focused on enhancing its contextual understanding. Logical reasoning and creative thinking are vital to push its boundaries of riddle solving. At least for now, the verdict is that the interplay between human creativity, intuition, and AI's analytical prowess holds the potential for AI to accurately unlock the most difficult riddles in history. And it is nowhere near making computers sentient enough to overthrow humans and take over the world yet.